Shannon Anderson. I'm a teacher and also a children's book author. I am here today to read you my book, Too Shy to Say Hi, which is illustrated by Jairo Nakata, and it's published by Magination Press, which is an imprint of the American Psychological Association. So, Too Shy to Say Hi. My dog and I walk every day, just the two of us. We pass some kids out playing ball. Let's go, Barnabas. Come and join us, Shelli, I hear one of them say. I give a tiny smile, but keep going on my way. My brave dog always wants to sniff everyone in sight. He tugs at me, but I tug back and pull with all my might. Barnabas has no trouble meeting friends hairless or furry. He goes right up and greets them without a single worry. We find a quiet spot at last beneath a shady tree. A neighbor runs past with her dog. I think she waved at me. What if I imagined it? Should I tell her hi? I can hardly say a word whenever I feel shy. At home, my parrot flaps her wings in her friendly way. Hi, hi, hello, Lulu squawks. Easy for you to say. The only one who understands eyes me from his cave. He loves his little hideaway, Stan the not so brave. I'm lucky to have three buddies with feathers, fins, and fur. I thought these friends would be enough. Now I'm not so sure. When I'm back at school next week, I want to give it a go. Will someone want to play with me? There's only one way to know. I stare at myself in the mirror. I wave and just say hi. It feels a little silly, but I know I want to try. In the morning, I decide, today will be the day. I'm going to find the courage to be friendly in small ways. I really want to be brave at school, but I'm having serious doubts. I know it won't feel good at all if I give up and chicken out. I've been scared for long enough, and I really want some friends. So I'm going to talk to someone before another school day ends. As the kids come into class, I look toward Lupita's spot. I make myself take a step, but my stomach is in knots. I take a single huge, deep breath. This is the moment that I feared. I turn the color of ketchup. What if she thinks I'm weird? Then I open my mouth to speak, like I practiced in the mirror. I manage to say the words, is anyone sitting here? Lupita looks up and smiles. Hi, Shelli, have a seat. I say thanks, put down my things, and breathe a sigh of relief. Wow, that really worked. It wasn't so hard, I guess. I think I could do it again and worry a little bit less. Soon it'll be time for recess. No swinging alone again. This might be the scariest part of my mission to make a friend. Things have gone well so far, but what am I going to say? I tap Lupita's shoulder and ask, at recess, do you want to play? Sure, do you want to shoot baskets or jump rope or play baseball? It all sounds good to me. This is the very best day of all. I don't need to worry and wonder. I don't have to feel scared. I can smile and say hello without having a speech prepared. Look out, world, it's Shelli. Today went really well. I know I have a ways to go, but I'm peeking out of my shell. And you see, she has a friend here for Stan the Not So Brave. So she made a friend with Lupita, and now Stan has a friend too. Now, I don't know if you've ever felt shy before or a little nervous. Maybe you're worried that if you ask someone to be your friend or you ask someone to play that they might say no or they might laugh or something. And so I hope that you will be thinking about what Shelli did in the story and how she practiced in the mirror and she took a deep breath when she felt nervous and she was able to just try little tiny steps toward making a friend. You know, just asking, is anyone sitting here? Or asking someone to play on recess. And you know, it will probably work out for you. Kindness always wins. If you're kind to other people, then they're going to want to be your friend. Now I have something that I made that you can make too. If you're ever feeling a little nervous or worried, then you can take a Kleenex box and you can make your very own worry monster. And so he says, feed me your worries. And so if you're feeling nervous or afraid about something, you could either draw a picture of it or you could write about it, and you can stick it right in here and let the worry monster have it. Because he likes to deal with worries. And that way you can just park it in there and you don't have to worry about it anymore. You can let the worry monster deal with it. And in the meantime, you can be thinking of positive ways that you can take little steps to try to be a little bit braver. Now, if you enjoyed the story, Too Shy to Say Hi, which I hope you did, you can get your own copy, of course, online through Magination Press or Amazon, Barnes and Noble, any place books are sold. And you can also just ask your public library if they will carry it, and you can tell them the title and that you would like to be able to check it out. So we hope you enjoyed the story. Have a good day.